It's Saturday. This is July 16th. All the other cows are down in the bottom of the field. There's this one cow up here in the corner. I'm gonna see if she's okay. I don't know if she's calving or something's wrong with her. She just had a baby. Look at that. You know, she was down when I drove up the... God, that's tight. When I drove up the lot, I mean, driveway. That's white ears. It's got white on her ears. What you got there, girl? Thought there was something wrong with you. I'm not going over there and messing with you. All right, well, new calf born. Ain't gotta worry about her. I got all my poles redone. Let's see. I took that Zepco Adventure and I put 20 pound sturdy braid on it. That's that braid that I got off Amazon. I got the 60 pound and the 20 pound. So we're going to try that. So redone that one. The Shimano 2000. Now, it's not the 2000 that they're selling now, but this is a FX 2000 RA, but the ones they got that you see online right now, they're black and they're also just slightly different. I put 17 pound vicious line on that one, and I think it's going to do really well, so we restrung that one. And it's on that Zepco sizzle stick. I switched the pole around too. Let's see. The Akuma Fina has 20 pound it's at Armor, Berkeley Armor line on it. And so it's on the Silstar Pro. I don't think I've done anything to that one. Let's see. I did the, I have the fold-up Johnson rod. I did dig out the Shakespeare Cirrus with, I think that's 12-pound Berkeley low visibility green on there. So I think it's 10-pound. So I did rig that one up differently. Now I switched some of the other poles around, and I got this Quantum Optics 40. I put on this Shoremaster 4.6 foot rod, and it does really well. So that's going to be one for the John boat. I had that dowel on there, but it's just a little too big reel for the John boat. I still have the Abu Garcia on the ugly stick. I didn't do anything to that. I found this in some of my dad's stuff. This is a Dawa Silver Cast 208RL. And it was missing the handle. So I took that handle off of an Abu Garcia reel that didn't work. And so... And it's got that Berkley ultra thin 8-pound line on it. I put on that, and it is a sweet. It's on that little Zepco Pro rod that you can switch the rod sticks in it. I think that's going to be a great John boat reel. And last but not least for the John boat, the one I caught that bass on this past weekend, that Abu Garcia Abumatic 170 that I put on just a Zepco 33 rod. It did really well. I really liked it. It cast as far as you want to cast, and it done really well. So that's a John boat rod. So there's the 8 John boat rods. I switched some things around. I put that dive on that big Shakespeare surf pier rod, and I switched that the one I used this past weekend, the Shakespeare Sigma Supra RT long cast. I put that on that old Tiger, Shakespeare Tiger rod. The rest of those I didn't do anything with. So that's what I've changed so far. And going to the auction is all this line. Man, look at all this line going to the auction. Somebody's going to score on this line. These are brand new 12 pound armor coated. There's some 10 pound spider wire, you name it. So got that, and I set up two tackle boxes with old tackle and baits and tools and stuff going to the auction. Somebody will bid on that with some junk in it. The top's pretty nice though. It's $100-$200 worth of stuff in there. And I set up this with just old crap. Sometimes you just gotta clean stuff out. That's going to the, all this stuff's going to the auction. Oh, let's see what's going in there. That worm gear. That's a total piece of crap. The worm gear pole broke. The reel is a total piece of crap. I used it in a couple videos. This little Omega reel is going. A Zepco reel. That Ted Williams reel. An old Zepco reel. This thing I got off of eBay, which I thought was going to be pretty decent, and it absolutely sucks. It's the Late Cast by Langley. And then this was the worst of all. This is the Procaster Tournament by Daiwa. It was the worst bait caster I've ever used. And Daiwa usually is pretty good. I don't know. There's been something wrong with the reel. Those are all going to the auction. They all work. Those two South Bend Condors, a small one and a large one, they suck. Let's see what was in this one. There's another Daiwa, which absolutely sucks. Some of them are not good. There's a Old Norse Shakespeare. There's a Gladding 2000 or 2202. That's a old one. There's an old Berkeley 415. All of these reels work. And then there's that Damn Quick 330 that my dad said it was one of his favorites, but I think it's crap because of the bale, workings of the bale. Maybe I just don't know how to do it. All these Zepcos, 202s, 404s. I think that's all that's in there is 202s and 404s. Yeah, 202s and 404s, all of them work. Look at that, there's another Shimano, like the Shimano that I like. And it works, but it's just a slightly different style. There's that Abu Garcia 276i that I bought last year. Did the review on it. I'm not. You know, I used it for a little while there. Bought it for Little Miss Muffet, but overall, I don't think it's very good. Zepco 33 in there. There's a iMEC bait caster reel and a Zepco 1. The Zepco 1 was horrible. Oh, thing that makes sinkers and a bunch of trot lines. Those are all going to the auction. Watch them sell them by the whole box for $5. Oh shit, won't I wrote on it, please sell by the bag. I'll sell them by the bag. You know, I get $25 a bag for these. Who knows? Maybe $10 on those. And buy more gear and get rid of the old gear that I don't use. These little sewing scissors, found them in the sewing section of any store that has a sewing section. They are great for cutting line. Absolutely wonderful. All right, so for Tom's farming, garden, fishing, boating, home brewing, media, reality, silly, hillbilly channel. I'm Tom Moore, and good luck to you.